Hi everyone, this is Patty. I'm here today with my project number one for my Mother Goose series, Not a Scrap Left. And I've used the three paper pads, the 12 by 12, the 8 by 8, and the 6 by 6 Graphic 45's Mother Goose. I also use Claire, my creative spirit. Claire and I have been friends for forever. And she sent me the tutorial for her Love and Laugh album, and I'll have the link to it down below. And that's what I have fashioned this mini after. I cut out the Mother Goose, fussy cut her out, and popped her up on the front. Then I had they're called fat quarters, I think. I'm not a quilter, but they're the little pieces of pre-cut cotton that you can get in the store. And I had these primary cut colored ones that I've had forever in my drawer, and I thought with the colors that are in the Mother Goose, this would just be perfect. So I cut them out and used the Tim Holtz tattered floral dye to make these flowers to go on the outside. And I have a couple charms. I have a stork down here and a Just For You and a moon. And then I took the outside of the 12 by 12, that's the checkerboard, and put it on the spine and on the back. And now I didn't like the shininess because the outside of the paper packs is a shiny, heavier paper. I liked that it was heavier, but I just didn't like that it was shinier. So I used Eileen's Collage Posh on it, a couple of coats. Not only does that make it sturdier, but it takes the shine away. And here I just fussy cut a piece out from the paper pack and put here the Mr. Moon and little Miss Muffet, maybe? I can't remember. Okay, let me show you what I've made here. And as I said, this is Claire's tutorial, so I will link to it. And if you want to make one that's following this design, you can purchase hers and it will show you how to do it. So on the first cover here, I took some of the stamps, backed them with some black, and put a couple of postcards in here and just slid them underneath. And then I have a pocket on the inside front, and in the pocket is this another pocket, is this pull-out mat, has room for a large 4x6 picture here. It has two tags that go in this little pocket here, and you actually could put one here if you wanted to, besides in the back. And then underneath is a little belly band and just this little one that opens with a couple more little tiny tags in it. I use some stickles here to make the quilt and the stars show up. These just slide right in there, and then they just slide underneath this little tiny belly band, right like that. And then this goes back in the pocket. Now on the first page here, this is a flip up. And it's got a little stopper down here. Humpty Dumpty's on the front of it. This was a piece of packaging. It's a heavyweight plastic that I've had forever, this little doily. But I just really liked the looks of how it made the bottom part of this flipper. And you flip it up, and I have a pocket here with a tag that goes inside. And then here is a belly band that goes across with a good size mat, and then this comes down and flips inside of there, and then you flip the page over. I have another belly band here, and I took one of these elements from, I don't know whether, I think it was the pockets and inserts, but I just put a strip of paper underneath so it looks like a little belt buckle. And then underneath here is this little booklet, room for journaling over here, and you open it up and you've got a pocket, you have room for a photo here, you have these little tags that go in, and this is one of the envelopes that come on that sheet that you can purchase with a tag that goes inside. I love, love, love this paper. It doesn't matter how old I get or how old my children get. It seems like someone is always having a baby somewhere in the family. So baby themed or young children themed paper is perfect always for me. I love seeing it. And you know, Graphic 45, their paper is gorgeous anyway. This is my Humpty page, and it's a short little pocket here. And I took and made this round one with a magnet. There's a magnet in between here, so it pops closed. And you open it up, and it's a trifold. It's got the belly band here that has a little insert that opens, comes out. You can write a little story. You can put your own pictures in here. And then it can either slide under here or it can slide under the belly band, whichever you want it. And then on this side, there's a pocket down here. This is a little tiny one here for memories. It says memories, childhood memories. And it just goes underneath in the pocket. There's two tags here, Humpty Dumpty. And on the back, and then I just cut out one of the little sayings from the paper and glued it down, put some stickles on it so it would kind of pop up a little bit. And these go in the pocket. And then there is a lollipop stick that goes in this one. And I just cut around the paper. Oops. And here's the lollipop stick. It just slides in there. And then it magnetizes closed. There's a little 5 cent there. And then on the back side of it is just a simple pocket with another journaling spot on one side, and you could put little pictures on this side. And on this side, this one opens. This is also a magnet. Now the magnets that I'm using in this are all basic gray, the magnetic discs, and I use the larger ones. And there's a pocket on the inside of this flip here, and with room on the back here for a photo and room on the back here for some journaling. I really like that on a lot of these there's room here to write something about your photos or your memories or what's going on. There's also room to put a picture here. On the opposite side on this page is this mat. And I fussy cut this out and then just put another one of these little books on the inside. Slides right in like that. And then it goes in this pocket here. And then this is one of the stickers that I matted it on black and then I matted it on the gold. And then it holds this little tiny book. How does your garden grow? And you can put pictures in there. And it just slips in there, and then this is magnetized again. And then you turn it. Now this one I did make into a pocket here. Now I did make some changes from what Claire had in her tutorial. You know how we are. We always like to have our own little hand and stuff. But this is just a little pocket. It holds, I think these hold 4x4 pictures. Put some journaling on the back, and it's got little boy blue here. And it just slides in the pocket. On this one, there's a mat in the very back with one of the flowers from the flower set that goes with the collection. Solid on the back. It slips behind here. And then there's another one that goes in here. Solid on the back. And it goes in and slips in like this, just underneath the Mother Goose. There we go. And the flower just kind of pops over the top that way. And now I have another one of these smaller ones here with a lollipop stick on the outside with some journaling lines on it. It magnetizes to the belly band on this side. Another lollipop stick here. And Claire's instructions are fantastic of showing you how to cut your lollipop strips, how to cut your belly band so that everything lines up just great. Here's a mat, a pocket with maybe, there we go, with a mat inside like this. And these are the pendants. And I just made them like a paper clip on both sides. And then I stretched my pocket the way Claire shows It's just that it kind of got hung up in there. There we go. And then it just slides underneath the belly band like this. And then I put these little stamps down there just to stop it from sliding straight on through. And then it closes with a snap with the magnet. And you turn the page and we have, let's see. Oh, this way. It's been a while since I've made this one. Okay, this one has another magnetic closure here. And it opens this way. And then we have the belly band. And then I have just a couple little tags that go in like that. And then it closes. And this now I made double so because a magnet's in here and it's very sturdy. I always like these things that are pop out, poke out, that you're going to be having a lot of interaction with to be several layers so that they don't wear through. On this page, there's a pop-up on the bottom that has a belly band with two little tags. And then a belly band with Humpty that I fussy cut out here and popped him on a couple different colors of paper. And with a little bitty tiny book that says Bedtime Story that just slides down over the top. And that closes with a magnet. And then this one, this little ribbon has been laying on my desk. I have no idea what it came on. But when I was making this that day, I thought, oh, that ribbon is just perfect. So I put it through the little eyelet. This is embossed. The Humpty Dumpty is embossed with the stamps. And then there's just three little tags here that you can put pictures on and some journaling, and they stick back behind. There's a tag that pulls out here with Humpty on it. This is from the stamp set. And it goes in. The first video that I did in this series, the intro video, will show you all of the other things that I used out of the collection. Here's the next page, and we have a little pullout here with more of the fussing cutting. There's another tag mat here, just plain, that you can put a picture and some journaling on. Another one of the little books that slides underneath here. And then on this side, I have a little tiny one of those. I think these are the Tim Holtz, the little tiny paper clips. And this one comes out. You can see, I think, maybe, that I have glossy accents on him to pop him up. Room for a picture on the back. And he just slides right underneath here, and that clip goes around to hold the stamp in place. And then this is fussy cut from the, this is one of the stickers. And then I cut the belly band and up around it to fussy cut so it would take the shape. Here's another mat with the flowers from the collection. And it slides in here. And then this one slides in. I guess I have to do it the other way around. This one slides in. Okay, got it. Pocket down here and slides underneath. I'll get it in a minute. Excuse me. Another one of the smaller ones. As you can see, we've got a larger one, a smaller one, a smaller one, a larger one, a smaller one, and a larger one. I really like the way that this is done. And this one pops open with a magnet again. And then I fussy cut from the paper and did some glitter and some glossy accents on them. And when you mat things like this one, the lamb and the little girl are all matted on the black, it gives it so much more stability in the book. And here's another little one. It opens like this, slides underneath. Pardon me. And then there's another lollipop stick here and another one that you could put pictures on, front and back. And it just slides in this little pocket here. And the lollipop stick in the middle. And then this one, there's another one that pulls out. This is the stamping up top tab punch. And this just comes out, slides in the pocket here, like that, and slides in here. I like the way my little flowers turned out. and another tag underneath here, and I've just put some journaling lines on it. And then it pops closed like that. We move to the next one. I have a belly band. Let me see. This one just has a belly band, and this one I'm not going to take out. You take this one out, you put your picture on and slide it back underneath. And I haven't done that. Yeah. And then on this one, with a little twinkle twinkle, I cut behind the little boy and then I put the tag in here, solid on both sides. And then I put the star up here that he's looking at. And here's another popsicle stick that goes back behind here. And then this one opens like this. We have a pocket inside. Lots and lots of interaction in this book. I just love these papers. With having all of the primary colors this way, I was able to pick up a lot of the cardstock, the color cardstock, in the primary colors to stretch my designer paper further. Here's another one, another mat. Fussy cut around the edge of the paper and then just left it here so it was open so you could stick quite a few pictures in there. Stamps across the top and it closes with a magnet. And then on this one we have another belly band with Humpty cut out this time on this one with another little book. Oh, take it back. This one's just a mat that slides underneath the decorative belly band here. And then this one, instead of being the smaller pocket page, this one is on the diagonal and it's a pocket like this with another one of the flowers on the front and the back. And it goes in like this. And then we have a little tiny envelope with an itsy bitsy little book inside. Like, here we go, there we go. Little bitty tiny book, and it goes right in here. And then that goes underneath here, and then this one, and it slides down to hold over the top of that one. And then when you turn it, there's another spot on this side that has another one of the little envelopes from the collection and just some various little tags that are inside. I used my corner chomper, my half inch round corner chomper, on a lot of these to give the curled edge there. And I'm gonna have to go back and put that. It's come up, but we'll fix that. And another little postcard. And then on the back page, I just have a little one. They'll hold two photos here. Another mat with a pocket. And another one here. And that just slides in here. This is a Martha Stewart punch here across the bottom that is on this one and the front. And then there's the back. So there's my book, using Claire's Tutorial and Graphic 45's Mother Goose Line. I hope you liked it. I just had so much fun making it. And stay tuned. There will be another mini coming shortly. And then after that, there will be another mini that I will have a tutorial for, all using the Mother Goose Graphic 45 papers. If you're not a subscriber, I hope you become one today. Comments are most welcome, always appreciated. I try to answer everyone. Thank you for joining me, everyone. Have a great day. Bye-bye.